Come, Holy Spirit, bless this unworthy priest that I may share with humility and with the heart. And that people listen with their hearts. Come, Holy Spirit, come. Sisters and brothers, there are only two First Fridays left in the year 2023. That's November First Friday and December First Friday. So God has been generous to all of us. And fast forward, before I forget, 17 na po ako, last October 1, forgetful. Tomorrow is First Saturday. We are going to have that walk with God to Manawag. So I've been doing since the 1980s, May, October, First Saturday, Walk with God from Urdaneta, Pangasinan, alas 5 po ng umaga, blessing. Walk 3 hours to Manawag, Shrine of Our Lady. A Thanksgiving walk, pasasalamat, petition walk, may hinihingi. Praying the rosary, sacrifice, and confessions. So, yung mga pwede pa, you're most welcome. Month of the Rosary, month of our dear Mother Mary. And, alam po nyo, one of the best motto. May motto ka ba? Ang motto ng mga boksingero, alam nyo, it's better to give than to receive. Ayun. Same with life. Are you a giver or are you a taker? The Lord always reminds us, be a giving person. Today, examine yourself. God has given us so much. Are we giving Him also? In terms of your time, your talents, your treasures. O, yung mga senior, payback time. Diba nung naalala ko nung we were growing up, I always heard the word, you know, small town, not much money, may tinatawag silang back pay. Back pay ba yun sa trabaho o kaya sa military? Back pay. Payback. So, giving. Question. One give plus one give equals two gives. Two gives plus two gives equals four gives. Four gives na tayo. And what are the four gifts? Paki-check po natin. To God, give Him the honor and obedience due to Him. Are you giving to God your gratitude? Marunong ka bang tumanaw sa Kanya na, Panginoon, kayo pong aking Panginoon? Give Him the obedience, the loyalty. Marami sa atin, we disobey God. Yabang natin, no? Parang sino tayo? And we don't even give back time. Busy tayo lahat. But we forget to give to God time to pray, to listen. Mayroon nga tinanong doon daw ng mayor, Sir, are you busy, sir? So, I'm not busy, huh? I'm mayor. Don't forget that. Masyado kang busy. Give God the honor. Today, tell the Lord, As for me and for my house, we will serve the Lord. The Book of Joshua. Lord, you are my God. Help me to live the rest of my life, the best of my life. Many times po, Lord, patawad po sa kayabangan namin. We do not listen enough. We even disobey you. Give God the honor and the glory. Second, give. What do you give to others? Give to others their rights. Bawat tao mayroong rights, no? Mayroon siyang karapatan na nararapat para sa kanya. If you don't give them their rights, you are violating them. First of all, you give respect to people. Yun lang pong acknowledge the presence of somebody, laking bagay na yun. Papunta ka sa isang room, wala lang, para ka lang, walang kilala. O kaya may dumating, wala lang, binabali. Yung konting musta, these are the little things we should start to say thank you. Yung security guard na tumulong, yung nagbuka, salamat po. Yung waiter na nag-serve, thank you. Bakit ako magpapasalamat? Binayaran ko naman mga yan. Yan ang problema ng iba eh, panay pera. Your money does not exempt you from respecting other people. Give them their rights. People have the right to be listened to. Makinig ka naman, salita ka ng salita eh. At huwag kang maging judgmental. May karapatan sila to be heard, to explain. So please, as you go through life, don't violate the rights of people. Give them their rights. Give them the chance to live. Yung mga pumapatay dyan, give them the chance to grow. Pati, basic po, whatever we do to others, we do it to the Lord. Number three, na give. Give the world a chance. Ito po sa mga nag-aabuso ng kalikasan. Kinuha nyo na lahat, nagpayaman kayo, pero ang daming nasira, ang daming kawawa. Give this world a chance. So, sa mga bata, susunod pa, mayroon pa silang makakantang, what a wonderful world. Kasakiman, ang dami po. Sana po, give the world a chance. Give peace a chance. Yung away-away, mga gera-gera na yan, what for? And finally, give yourself a break. What does it mean? Give yourself a break from bad habits. Yung kaluluwa mo hindi mag-grow kasi nakafocus ka palagi sa mga pleasures ng katawan. Give yourself a break from being proud. Akala mo kung sino ka and you don't have the time to have peace. Pag mayabang ka po, ang dami kang kaaway, daming galit sa'yo, ang daming halos nagdadasal. Lord, kunin mo na siya, Lord. Mga ganon. Why do you keep on going with toxic people na wala nang ginawa kundi maggumawa ng mga chismisan? Give yourself a break from them. You are not obliged to drown with them. Stay away from toxic people. Stay away from bad talks. Stay away from negativities. Give yourself a break from sin. Okay? Forgives. Give God the honor and the glory due unto Him. And what do you give to other people? Give others their rights. And what do you to give to the world? Give the world a break, a chance, and give yourself a break from sin and negativities. Forgives. One get plus one get equals two gets. Two gets plus two gets equals four gets. Yun naman ang four gets natin. Forgives, forgets. Number one, get to the Lord again. Get closer to God. Are you closer to God now than when you were 1 year, 3 year, 5 years ago? Masasabi bang mas personal na ang, mas real na yung relationship with the Lord? Dami kasi sa atin, dasal ng dasal, pero pareho pa rin ang asal. We are not listening. Parang ginawa lang natin si Lord na sandalan, pero wala namang nangyayari. Listen to God. Get real with God. Sana maging more personal. Get real. Number two, sorry, what did I say? Get closer to God. Number two, sa ibang tao, get real with people. Magpakatotoo ka sa kapwa-tao. To get real means, hindi na ako plastic. This is me. To get real means, tinatanggap kita, whoever you are, ako rin ganito, tanggapin mo. Sana mas real mga relationships natin, mas real ang samahan natin sa mga pangako natin. Get real. Panay ka showbiz, panay ka pakitang tao, panay ka lang one for the money, two for the show. Mas maganda po yung get real with yourself. You're at peace. Lord, this is me. And if you can say this, look, I'm not that good as others think I am. No, I'm not that good. But I'm not that bad either. Hindi rin ako ganun kasama. And you're comfortable with that already. Okay na yun. You become more real. Number three, with the world. Get involved with the world. Anong involvement mo? Lalang, TV-TV lang ako, Father. Napapanood. Yung mga panay-panood, at least nagdadasal ka, pinagdadasal mo yung mga nakikita mo. That's one. Meron ka bang outreach? Meron ka bang tinutulungan? Sabi niya, Father, may apostolate ako. Nag-aalaga ng mga apo. Yeah. Cute, no? Pero okay naman po yon. But is that all, family? Is there something else? Ang daming naghihirap. Mayroon ka bang pwedeng matulungan? And get involved with the word in prayer. Yung intercessory prayer. Kahit di ka lumalabas, basta pinagdadasal ko, Panginoon, mga pare, mga may sakit. You are interceding for others. You're getting involved with the world. And finally, with yourself. Senior na ako. Get. Mamaya babalik yan. Ganun talaga pala pag senior. Nandyan lang yan. So, get closer to God. Number two, with people, get real with people. And number three, with the world, get involved with the world. And number four, tignan nyo, get out of your shell. Palagi kang merong safety, comfort zones. Alam po nyo, sa mga nagbibiyahe, you go to different time zones. Bahira po to cross the different time zones. Pero alam nyo, mas mahirap to cross your comfort zones. Usually, ayaw natin eh. Sigurado na ako dito. Ayaw ko. Basta this is my comfort zone. Alauna ng tanghali, walang mga kadistorbo sa akin. Kahit may patay kung ano. Comfort zone yan eh. But if you really, if you want to really get out of your shell, you go. Go the extra mile, give the extra smile. Mga kapatid, this is the call of the heart. Kung wala pong puso, wala lahat yan. Doesn't make sense. Kung logic lang pag-usapan natin yung sinasabi ni Lord, sorry ah, malaking katangahan. Lugi ka. Nakikipag-dialogue, dialogue pa dyan. Wala nang dialogue, dialogue. Dialogue, nadaya ka na, nalugi ka pa. Hindi. Commander na ako, tapos na ito. You see, you go. But you can only understand what the Lord is saying with the heart. Mga kapatid, this is my prayer for all of us. May we open our hearts always to the Holy Spirit so that we can truly understand and truly love. If your spirituality is all about righteousness, just keeping the commandments, keeping the rules, if that's all you're doing, are we better than the Pharisees of old who followed the law, the letter of the law, but they had no heart for God, for people? Naging legalistic ka lang, naging righteous ka lang. At 70, mga kapatid, more and more I realize the meaning that many times it's better to be kind than to be right. So right. And it's better to be expressive than to be impressive. Tama na yung pa-impress, mag-express na lang tayo. Little things mean a lot. Yeah, and huwag na masyado yung hard work. Gawin na natin heart work. Amen and amen. Mama Mary, we still have so much to learn about true loving and true humility. Teach us, Mama Mary, to follow your Son, to be more prayerful, to be more humble, to be more kind, and to be more joyful. May the darkness of sin and the night of unbelief vanish before the light of the Word and the Spirit of grace. And may the heart of Jesus live in the hearts of men. Take note, the favorite prayer of our founder said, may the heart of Jesus live in the hearts of all men, all people. He did not say, may the wisdom of Jesus, may the righteousness of Jesus, may the eloquence of Jesus. He said, may the heart of Jesus live in the hearts of all. And one more thing, for those who think they know everything, that they are intelligent and bright and smart. Look, God is the most intelligent. We can never, you know, no comparison. But God called himself, I am the Sacred Heart. He didn't call himself, I am the sacred brain. So heart. So one more time then. Before we go on, let's do it together. Big heart. Oh God, you are the biggest heart. Thank you. We are in your heart. You absorb, accept all of us in your loving heart. Human heart. Lord, make our hearts more human. more loving, more gentle, more generous, more giving. Small heart, chakan ma'am, may we have a heart for the little ones, the children, the poor, the sick, those who have nothing, those who have no one. And may we not be afraid to share our hearts and to connect with people heart to heart. One heart, connect with people. Yung mga senior, paano ba yan? Arthritis. Don't forget to have a happy heart. Amen. Take care. The Lord always reminds us, be a giving person. Today, examine yourself. God has given us so much. Are we giving Him also? In terms of your time, your talents, your treasures. O, yung mga senior, payback time. Diba nung naalala ko nung we were growing up, I always heard the word, in a small town, not much money, may tinatawag silang back pay. Back pay ba yun sa trabaho o kaya sa military? Back pay. Payback. So, giving. Question. One give plus one give equals two gives. Two gives plus two gives equals four gives. Four gives na tayo. And what are the four gifts? Paki-check po natin. To God, give Him the honor and obedience due to Him. Are you giving to God your gratitude? Marunong ka bang tumanaw sa Kanya na, Panginoon, kayo pong aking Panginoon? Give Him the obedience, the loyalty. Marami sa atin, we disobey God. Yabang natin, no? Parang sino tayo? And we don't even give back time. Busy tayo lahat. But we forget to give to God time to pray, to listen. Mayroon nga tinanong doon daw na mayor, sir, are you busy, sir? So, I'm not busy, ah. I'm mayor. Don't forget that. Masyado kang busy. Give God the honor. Today, tell the Lord, as for me and for my house, we will serve the Lord. The book of Joshua. Lord, you are my God. Help me to live the rest of my life, the best of my life. Many times po, Lord, patawad po sa kayabangan namin. We do not listen enough. We even disobey you. Give God the honor and the glory. Second give, what do you give to others? Give to others their rights. Bawat tao mayroong rights, no? Mayroon siyang karapatan na nararapat para sa kanya. If you don't give them their rights, you are violating them. First of all, you give respect to people. Yun lang pong acknowledge the presence of somebody, laking bagay na yun. Papunta ka sa isang room, wala lang, para ka lang, walang kilala. O kaya may dumating, wala lang, binabali. Yung kunting, kumusta? These are the little things we should start to say thank you. Yung security guard na tumulong, yung nagbuka, salamat po. Yung waiter na nag-serve, thank you. Bakit ako magpapasalamat? Binayaran ko naman mangyan. Yan ang problema ng iba eh, panay pera. Your money does not exempt you from respecting other people. Give them their rights. People have the right to be listened to. Makinig ka naman, salita ka ng salita eh. At huwag kang maging judgmental, may karapatan sila to be heard, to explain. So please, as you go through life, don't violate the rights of people. Give them their rights. Give them the chance to live. Yung mga pumapatay dyan. Give them the chance to grow. Pati, basic po, whatever we do to others, we do it to the Lord. Number three, na give. Give the world a chance. Ito po sa mga nag-aabuso ng kalikasan. Kinuha nyo na lahat, nagpayaman kayo, pero ang daming nasira, ang daming kawawa. Give this world a chance. So, sa mga bata, susunod pa, mayroon pa silang makakantang What a Wonderful World. Kasakiman, ang dami po. Sana po, give the world a chance. Give peace a chance. Yung away-away, mga gera-gera na yan, what for? And finally, give yourself a break. What does it mean? Give yourself a break from bad habits. Yung kaluluwa mo hindi mag-grow kasi nakafocus ka palagi sa mga pleasures ng katawan. Give yourself a break from being proud. Akala mo kung sino ka, and you don't have the time to have peace. Pag mayabang ka po, ang dami kang kaaway, daming galit sa'yo, ang daming halos nagdadasal, Lord, kunin mo na siya, Lord. Mga ganon. Why do you keep on going with toxic people? Na wala nang ginawa kundi mag-gumawa ng mga chismisan. Give yourself a break from them. You're not obliged to drown with them. Stay away from toxic people. Stay away from bad talks. Stay away from negativities. Give yourself a break from sin. Okay? Forgives. Give God the honor and the glory due unto Him. And what do you give to other people? Give others their rights. And what do you give to the world? Give the world a break, a chance, and give yourself a break from sin and negativities. Forgives. One get plus one get equals two gets. Two gets plus two gets equals forgets. Yun naman ang forgets natin. Forgives, forgets. Number one, get to the Lord again. Get closer to God. Are you closer to God now than when you were 1 year, 3 year, 5 years ago? Masasabi bang mas personal na ang, mas real na yung relationship with the Lord? Dami kasi sa atin, dasal ng dasal, pero pareho pa rin ang asal. We are not listening. Parang ginawa lang natin si Lord na sandalan, pero wala namang nangyayari. Listen to God. Get real with God. Sana maging more personal. Get real. Number two, sorry, what did I say? Get closer to God. Number two, sa ibang tao, get real with people. Magpakatotoo ka sa kapwa-tao. To get real means, hindi na ako plastic. This is me. To get real means, tinatanggap kita, whoever you are, ako rin ganito, tanggapin mo. Sana mas real mga relationships natin, mas real ang samahan natin sa mga pangako natin. Get real. Panay ka showbiz, panay ka pakitang tao, panay ka lang one for the money, two for the show. Mas maganda po yung get real with yourself. You're at peace. Lord, this is me. And if you can say this, look, I'm not that good as others think I am. No, I'm not that good. But I'm not that bad either. Hindi rin ako ganun kasama. And you're comfortable with that already. Okay na yun. You become more real. Number three, with the world, get involved with the world. Anong involvement mo? Lalang, TV-TV lang ako, Father. Napapanood. No, yung mga panay-panood, at least nagdadasal ka, pinagdadasal mo yung mga nakikita mo. That's one. Meron ka bang outreach? Meron ka bang tinutulungan? Sabi mo, Father, may apostolate ako. Nag-aalaga ng mga apo. Yeah. Cute, no? Pero okay naman po yun. But is that all, family? Is there something else? Ang daming naghihirap. Mayroon ka bang pwedeng matulungan? And get involved with the word in prayer. Yung intercessory prayer. Kahit di ka lumalabas, basta pinagdadasal ko, Panginoon, mga pare, mga may sakit, you are interceding for others. You're getting involved with the word. And finally, with yourself, senior na ako, get, mamaya babalik yun. Ganun talaga pala pag senior. Nandiyan lang yan. So, get closer to God. Number two, with with people, get real with people. And number three, with the world, get involved with the world. And number four, tignan nyo, get out of your shell. Palagi kang merong safety, comfort zones. Alam po nyo, sa mga nagbibiyahe, you go to different time zones. Mahirap po to cross the different time zones. Pero alam nyo, mas mahirap to cross your... I'm here, present Lord, sapagkat you invited me to be here today. I'm happy to be here, Lord. Lord, medyo may transaction sana, may trabaho, pero I'm here. Kayo pong mauuna, mahirap ang buhay, but I'm here to pray, to honor you, God. Lord, may problema. Halos ayaw ko pumunta. I have so many problems. Maybe, Lord, I'm not feeling well. But I'm here, Lord, to honor your invitation. Or maybe some of you would say, Lord, sana mayroong excursion. This time, dapat nasa mall na ako. But for you, Lord, I'm here. I'm here to honor your invitation. Yes, Lord, maraming salamat po for giving me the chance to be here. And I'm happy I am here, O Lord. Reporting, Lord, this morning. And the Lord looks at you and just smiles at you. Salamat. Salamat, anak. Sa pagmamahal mo, sakripisyo mo, effort mo to be here to honor my invitation. Thank you for your personal appearance before the Lord this morning. Amen. To acknowledge yung katabi mo, appear nga tayo. Appear. Thank you. Salamat. Appear tayo. Ah, batid, may mga combination, no? You combine guava and apple, what do you have? Guapple. Yo. Huh? You combine apple and pear, yung fruit na pear. Apple and pear, what do you have? A pear. A pear ulit tayo. A pear. Yay. question. Yung mga ibon ba may kamay? Do birds have hands? No? Eh bakit? Why do birds suddenly appear? Every time you are near. Kantayin nga natin. Why do birds suddenly appear? Every time you are near. Just like you. They long to be close to you. Your coming here is coming close to God. Thank you for making that effort. Mga kapatid, we are invited to the feast. Ano ba yung feast? Fiesta, handaan, may okasyon. And all are invited. But many do not respond to the invitation, not just to a feast, but the invitation of God to come close to His heart, the invitation of God for all of us to be good, to be kind, to be generous, and final invitation to heaven. But some do not respond. Mga iba po, walang appreciation sa invitation. They don't appreciate, no appreciation to the invitation. At mga iba naman, they appreciate pero walang appearance, walang aparisyon para sa invitation. Bakit po? Why do some people snob? the invitation of God to come closer, to be more good? Why do some people refuse? Or dead ma? Mayroon pong tatlong rason. Pakicheck po natin. Bakit ayaw mo, iniis na mo yung invitasyon? Kasi para sa iba, mas mahalaga yung commission. How many keep on working and don't even come 1 hour of the week just to be here, Lord? I'm here, reporting, Lord. Bahala na mga ibang transaction, basta I'm here. Thank you. Please don't forget that. Pera. Why do people disobey God and become selfish and greedy? Pera. Why do people hurt other people? Go all the way to wars. Greed. So mga kapatid, pera. Remember the story about this man? Naglalakad. He saw $1. Oh my God, sabi niya. Kinuha niya yung $1. Wow, $1. Happy ending na sana. But you know what happened to that man? Magmula nang nakakita ng $1, every time maglakad siya, ganito na. $1. Hindi na siya tumitingin sa mukha ng mga ibang tao. Hindi, $1. Hindi na siya tumitingin sa mukha ng family, friends niya. Oh, wala na, $1, basta $1. And worse, this man even forgot to look up to God. Kasi $1. Sisters and brothers, kailangan po ang pera, pero huwag mong kakalimutan, God is bigger than money. God is bigger than your material possessions. Sisters and brothers, ang pinakamalungkot siguro, when we come before God at the end of our lives, and the Lord looks at you and says, you know what? You made money your God. Ginawa mong Diyos mo ang pera at mga luho sa mundo. I am God. I am the God who made you, who loved you. Sana po, huwag natin madinig lang. The Lord tells us again, look at the birds in the air. They neither sow nor reap, but your Father takes care of them. Many of us become so insecure about money because we don't want to be poor. Of course, who wants to be poor? But to the extent na sobra-sobra ng money mo, what's that? And you don't even share that. Use your money for your salvation, not for your condemnation. May I repeat? Dalawang bagay po. When you come before God with all your wealth, two questions. Number one, is this good money or dirty money? Claro. Before God, wala na tayong matatago eh. Good money, you work hard for it, okay. But ito, yung nagnakaw ka, nangmurakot ka, you know, all that thing, that will be used for your condemnation. Second question is, wow, you had so much money, how much did you share? So be careful of dirty money and unshared money. And today we reflect what the Lord tells us. What does it profit a man? You gain the whole world, but in the end you lose your soul. Mark chapter 8 verse 37. Bakit hindi ka pumunta sa invitasyon? Baka dahil sa commission. Pangalawa po, why do people don't go to the invitation, the feast? The invitation to be good, to be close to God. Kasi Father, ang dami akong consumisyon. You're so engrossed in your problems. And you don't even have time for God. Kasi dapat masolve ko ito. Dapat magbago na siya. Dapat, you know, you're so engrossed always in your pains and sufferings. And we forget to find God in our pain and suffering. He's there. You know, when we become so much in pain, we become selfish. Focus on ourselves. Kapatid, sana your pain, your suffering and problems, mga consumption mo should bring you closer to God. make you a more understanding people, make you a better person, not a bitter person. Kapatid, focus on the Lord, not on the load. And what does the Lord tell us today? Lahat na may contribution, claro, come. All the more you should come. Come to me, all you are tired and heavily burdened, and I will give you rest. Huwag mong palakihin yung problema mo. Make God bigger than your problems. Lahat naman tayo may problema. Pero kung palagi kang problem-oriented, yan na lang kwento mo sa lahat ng mga tao, talk God. Talk God, oh my God loves me. That's it, tapos na. Huwag ka lang magkwento ng litany of your sufferings and pains. Don't. Rather, talk about the goodness of God. Alam ko, mahal ako ni Lord. Kaya ko ito. This is what it means. So, come to me. Matthew chapter 11, 28. Bakit hindi mo na maunlakan yung invitasyon? Kasi ang dami kong consolation. Mali po. Find God sa mga consolation mo. And number three, bakit hindi maunlakan? Why you don't honor the invitation of God? Kasi marami ka pang intermission sa buhay. The pleasures, mga attachments natin, mga luho natin. We're so attached to worldly pleasures and achievements. Sometimes we set aside God's invitation. Mga bisyo po. Kanya-kanya po tayong mga weaknesses. So, we are all a work in progress. Don't give up. Keep trying. Slowly. Cleansing. Up to the very end, we'll struggle. Ano bang weakness mo? Father, pagkain. Oh, yan. Well, okay. Pero huwag mo. Ikaw na lang kaya tignan mo yung katabi mo. Ano kaya palagay mong weakness niyan? We all have weaknesses. But again, the Lord invites us. Seek first the kingdom of God. And all this will be added unto you. And do not be discouraged. We all have weaknesses. But again, you say, Lord, these are my sins, weaknesses, but you are bigger than all my sins. So mga kapatid, what do we do today? The Lord tells you, anak, make sana my feast bigger than your worldly feasts. Fiesta ka. Mga pinagpiyestahan mo sa buhay mo dito, that's nothing compared to the feast that the Lord is inviting. Kapatid, you can experience true peace if you really learn to let go and say, God, you are bigger than commission. God, you're bigger than my consolation. And God, you are bigger sa mga more than my own intermission. Sisters and brothers, just to remind you, all are invited. We are a work in progress. And please don't forget, invite others also. Mayroon ka na bang nailapit kay Lord? Your husband, has he come closer to God because of you? Vice versa, the wife. The children, are they closer to God because of you? Yung mga kasama natin sa bahay, are they closer to God because of your kindness and goodness? So mga kapatid, all in, come one, come all. Only food, only lahat. So please, don't snub the invitation of God. And as I speak, there's a song that comes to my mind. In the 1960s, Peter, Paul, and Mary had this song about the cruel war is raging. As we speak, we pray for peace. Peace in the world, in Israel. We remember Angeline Aguirre and other caregivers who stayed with their master till the very end. Filipino loyalty and humanity. Sana po, no more wars. The cruel war is raging. Soldiers have to fight. Let us go on praying. No more wars again. Tama na po, Lord. Tama na po. Tama na po. And today also, amidst all these things happening, let us remember Santa Teresa of Avila. Feast day niya ngayon. And what is this? Her beautiful prayer. Let nothing disturb you. Please bow your head now. Maybe you're being disturbed by commission matters, pera matters. Maybe what's disturbing you now is your consumption and problems. Maybe what's disturbing you now is your intermission, mga luho, mga weaknesses, failures natin. Listen to Saint Teresa tell all of us today, let nothing disturb you. Let nothing frighten you. All things are passing. God never changes. Patience obtains everything. He who has God wants nothing. God alone suffices. Solo Dios basta. Let nothing disturb you. Nada te turbe. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Thank you, Mama Mary. Thank you, saints and martyrs. Thank you, guardian angels. And please tell the person beside you, thank you. You are here today. Appear tayo. Thank you, Father. Lose your soul. Matthew, Mark chapter 8, verse 37. Bakit hindi ka pumunta sa invitasyon? Baka dahil sa commission. Pangalawa po, why do people don't go to the invitation, the feast? The invitation to be good, to be close to God. Kasi Father, ang dami akong consumisyon. You are so engrossed in your problems. And you don't even have time for God. Kasi dapat ma-solve ko ito. Dapat magbago na siya. Dapat, you know, you are so engrossed always in your pains and sufferings. And we forget to find God in our pain and suffering. He's there. That, you know, when we become so much in pain, we become selfish. Focus on ourselves. Kapatid, sana your pain, your suffering and problems, mga consumisyon mo, should bring you closer to God. Make you a more understanding people. Make you a better person, not a bitter person. Kapatid, focus on the Lord, not on the load. And what does the Lord tell us today? Lahat na may consumisyon, claro, come. All the more you should come. Come to me. All you are tired and heavily burdened, and I will give you rest. Huwag mong palakihin yung problema mo. Make God bigger than your problems. Lahat naman tayo may problema. Pero kung palagi kang problem-oriented, yan na lang kwinekwento mo sa lahat ng mga tao, talk God. Talk God. Oh my God loves me. That's it. Tapos na. Huwag ka nang magkwento ng litany of your sufferings and pains. Don't. Rather, talk about the goodness of God. Alam ko, mahal ako ni Lord. Kaya ko ito. This is what it means. So, come to me. Matthew chapter 11:28. Bakit hindi mo na maunlakan yung invitasyon kasi ang dami kong konsumisyon. Mali po. Find God sa mga konsumisyon mo. And number three, bakit hindi maunlakan? Why you don't honor the invitation of God? Kasi marami ka pang intermission sa buhay. The pleasures, mga attachments natin, mga luho natin. We are so attached to worldly pleasures and achievements. Sometimes we set aside God's invitation. Mga bisyo po, kanya-kanya po tayong mga weaknesses. So, we are all a work in progress. Don't give up. Keep trying. Slowly. Cleansing. Up to the very end, we'll struggle. Ano bang weakness mo? Father, pagkain. Oh, yan. Oh, well, okay. Pero huwag mong... Ikaw na lang kaya tignan mo yung katabi mo. Ano kaya palagay mong weakness niyan? We all have weaknesses. But again, the Lord invites us. Seek first the kingdom of God. And all this will be added unto you. And do not be discouraged. We all have weaknesses. But again, you say, Lord, these are my sins, weaknesses, but you are bigger than all my sins. So mga kapatid, what do we do today? The Lord tells you, anak, make sana my feast bigger than your worldly feasts. Fiesta ka. Kung pinagpiestahan mo sa buhay mo dito, that's nothing compared to the feast that the Lord is inviting. Kapatid, you can experience true peace if you really learn to let go and say, God, you are bigger than commission. God, you are bigger than my consummation. And God, you are bigger sa mga more than my own intermission. Sisters and brothers, just to remind you, all are invited. We are a work in progress. And please don't forget, invite others also. Mayroon ka na bang nailapit kay Lord? Your husband, has he come closer to God because of you? Vice versa, the wife. The children, are they closer to God because of you? Yung mga kasama natin sa bahay, are they closer to God because of your kindness and goodness? So mga kapatid, all in, come one, come all. Only, only food, only lahat. So please, don't snub the invitation of God. And as I speak, there's a song that comes to my mind. In the 1960s, Peter, Paul, and Mary had this song about the cruel war is raging. As we speak, we pray for peace. Peace in the world, in Israel. We remember Angeline Aguirre and other caregivers who stayed with their master till the very end. Filipino loyalty and humanity. Sana po, no more wars. The cruel war is raging. Soldiers have to fight. Let us go on praying. No more wars again. Sana po, Lord. Tama na po. Tama na po. And today also, amidst all these things happening, let us remember Santa Teresa of Avila, feast day niya ngayon. And what is this? Her beautiful prayer. Let nothing disturb you. Please bow your head now. Maybe you're being disturbed by commission matters, pera matters. Maybe oh.